Hello, in this particular lecture, we are going to see defect root cause analysis with the help of a practical example. So let's start with our topic. So we will see the life cycle of defect root cause analysis with example. So from where this root cause analysis starts? It starts with customer complaints, and that is the effect. If you have a defect in your system, but why the customer is complaining? Customer is complaining because of the failure, because he has come across some failure. And what is the failure? It is incorrect interest payment calculation. So customer is trying to perform some interest calculation, but he is not getting output as per the expectation, and that is why it is a failure. When we are analyzing it, we found that this failure is due to single line of incorrect code. That is a defect, that there is a code which is not correct, and because of which we see this failure, and customer is not happy about it and he is complaining. Now when we further debug and we try to find out why this particular code is not fine, we see that the code was not written correctly. But why? Because the product owner misunderstood how to calculate interest. So he don't know how to calculate the interest. But we will not stop here, because the product owner has done a mistake, and because of which all these things has happened. But we have to understand why the product owner could not understand, because we have a complete team, and then how he missed to understand how to calculate the interest, which is an important feature of the software. So we have to further analyze, and then we found that since he has not understood, that means he needs some training. So what action we have to do? The product owner could be trained in the topic of interest calculation. So we have to train the product owner. If we train the product owner, then he will not write the wrong code. And if the code is not wrong, then all the lines of the code will be fine. And the interest calculation also will be okay, and customer will not complain. So that is how they all are related with each other. So I hope you have understood now that how this particular root cause analysis works, and from where it starts and where it has to end. So we have also to take some action so that we will not repeat this type of issues again. Now let's see the importance of this root cause analysis. So we will try to answer why we need to perform this root cause analysis. So the first point over here is to prevent a significant number of future defects from being introduced. So now we know that because of interest calculation there was a problem. So now we will see other type of calculations, whether that particular product owner has understood that or not. So all the future defects we can prevent. So that is one effect of this root cause analysis. Now let's see the second point, that is to reduce the occurrence of similar defects in the failure. So all this calculation type of mistake, again we will see and see that they are not again seen by the customer. So this is the second point. And the last point, that is the third point, is to improve the process. If we find that though the review is happened, still why this particular issue has missed, so that way we can also improve our process. We can add some additional measures in order to find such type of defects. So there are three points why we need to have a root cause analysis. First one is to prevent significant future defects, to reduce the occurrence of similar defects, or to prevent or to improve the process. So hope you have understood this particular topic, and that is it from this particular topic. I will see you with my next topic. Until then, happy testing.